Some sunshine tomorrow afternoon, but lots of sunshine for the weekend with highs in the mid to upper 70s. Johnny?
Beautiful forecast for one of the great events here in the Lowcountry. Time to get gritty, everybody. The Quaker Grits Festival is here this weekend. They'll be rolling in the grits up in St. George. Richard Meyer from the Grits Festival, along with radio personality Ryan Walker, join me right now with much, much more. Guys, welcome to the program. Richard, I want to start with you. Tell us all about the Grits Fest. This is one of the most special, unique, and fantastic events that we have here in the Lowcountry.
Thank you. This will be the 28th year that we've had a Grits Festival in St. George, so it's been running a long time. It's a family-oriented festival. It'll start tomorrow. Of course, Saturday's our big day. We'll have a 5K race that kicks off at 9 o'clock. Mm-hmm. We'll have a parade at 11 o'clock. It's always tremendous, the parade is. And our parade marshal this year is Mr. Rutt Murray. He's a World War II veteran, so he lives in St. George, and we're very proud of him.
Well, sounds fantastic. Why celebrate grits this much, Richard?
Well, a survey was done several years ago, and it came up with the conclusion that St. George, in that area around St. George, consume more grits per capita than any other area.
I did not know that.
Right.
How do you like your grits?
I like it cooked, and I like yellow grits. Yellow is a little more creamy to me. We have the white and the yellow. But I favor the yellow grits a little bit.
Well, a whole bunch of great competitions going on associated with the Grits Festival. And Ryan, I want to bring you in here right now because Rolling in the Grits, it's some of the best video we show on this channel all the time. People just love it.
It's unbelievable. It's the Rolling in the Grits contest and the Quaker Grits is definitely, to me, one of the highlights of the entire weekend. It's a lot of fun to be had, but when you see people diving headfirst into a kiddie pool full of grits, it just makes you so thankful that you're not the one diving in the
grits. Tell me how it works, because, I mean, you can see it right there. It seems like a pretty simple concept, but people really strategize.
They do, absolutely. Well, they obviously, first they start by filling they fill the pool full of grits, and then Richard here actually weighs you, so it's all about weight. So they weigh you when you first are about to jump in. Richard will weigh you, then you dive in, 10 to 15 seconds to get as many grits on your body as possible, and then you get out very carefully because it gets slippery after you've covered your entire body in grit. And then Richard will weigh you again, and the difference in weight is your score. Last year, I was so impressed with this one girl last year. We have the kids go on Saturday, adults on Sunday.
Sure.
There was a girl who was, do you remember, 13 years old?
She's like 13,
yeah,
I think.
Who ended up with like 29 pounds of grits on her person. Yes.
Right, we have an adult rolling, which takes place Sunday, and we have the children roll Saturday.
Yeah.
I think the record so far over the 28 years of the festival is like 53 pounds.
Where do people put it, Richard? That's my question.
They put it anywhere. In the cap, in the shirt, in the pants, everywhere. They can get the weight.
It's one of those questions you just don't want to ask.
Exactly.
You just don't want to know.
How do people sign up to be able to roll in the grits, Ryan?
You go to the 96.9 The Wolf website. So it's 969thewolf.com. Mm-hmm. You'll find a link right there on the homepage for the Quaker Grits Festival for the Rolling in the Grits. And you can sign up. Kids 5 to 9, 10 to 14, and then 15 plus adults.
And anybody can go if they sign up?
Yeah. Well, they pick from the people who can register online. We'll pick 9 in each category, as well as a couple on the day of.
Right.
And then they'll actually
What do you get if you win, aside from some soggy pants full of grits?
Yeah, there's a cash prize. A lot of it's pride, though. A lot of pride to say.
I'm sure. A lot of other great events. There's going to be great food, a lot of family activities as well. There's a corn shucking contest.
Right. Corn shucking contest, corn shelling contest. We got arts and crafts. We got dancing in the street. It's just a big family fun time.
Do people have to get tickets, Richard, or you just show up?
No tickets. Just show up and be sure and come by our family meal, the Myers family meal, and we'll be running the meal some and demonstrating the meal. My family's all there and involved in it.
Well, gentlemen, we appreciate you being here. It is not to be missed. Go check out that website right there for more information.
Thank you.
Enjoy it. All right, now for a 30-second health tip from Dr. Ross.